What excites me now about what I'm doing is I'm sort of taking all this information I've got over the past 10 or 12 years, and I'm actually returning back to a minimal kind of way of looking at things. So I'm making these things that are creating threads of color with clay, and then they're being dissected and opened up. So every time you set something up, you're organizing this clay or this structure, and then you open it up and be surprised, just like you'd be surprised if you opened a kiln and all of a sudden there's this incredible thing you can see. And that sense of serendipity is so engaging for me, and hopefully that it's engaging for the people who see it. There's been so many times that I've had an idea that's been sustained for a long time. In other words, I've been in pursuit of something. I've seen it on the horizon, I've been looking at it, trying to find it. Eventually, I kind of could bring the things that fit together down into some place where I could understand it and to make something powerful. It's like Legos. It's, when they click together, it's really cool. You know, just pop, you know, go, wow, look at that. And I think it goes back to trying to understand my world and to bring those things that create some kind of structure or harmony or beauty, or even communicate other emotions like angst and fear and death. It makes itself tangible at that point. It's no longer just an idea or a thought or something way out there, but it's made itself all the way back to become reality. And to me, that's just, you know, that's what feeds me. I mean, that's my bowl of oatmeal.